be subsidiary, then what will happen is as follows. So initially my budget line is P1 X1 plus P2 X2 is equal to M, and now I am saying that there is, so per unit of good one that you consume, you get a 10% subsidiary on the price, subsidy on the price. So then what happens is as follows. So the price was P1, but you get back some amount, 10% of P1 you get back. So the new price is actually P1 1 minus 10 by 100, or this can also be written as P1 1 minus S by 100. So the new equation will be P1 1 minus S by 100 into X1 plus P2 into X2 is equal to M. So this will be your new equation. Okay, so just understand, it's very easy now, that in a way the price of good one has fallen. So whenever the price falls, we know that there would be a rightward rotation of the budget line. So this more or less finishes chapter 2 of variant. So what are the things that we have learned in chapter 2 of variant? So the things that we have learned in chapter 2 are as follows. 1. What is a budget line? What is a budget constraint? What happens when income increases or decreases? What happens when price change? What are the different taxes? What are the different subsidies? And what is rationing? And what are the different measures taken by the government? It can either be free quantity for certain units, or it can be lower price for certain units. Then we learned what is a numerator price and what are composite goods. So this finishes chapter 2. Okay, thank you. Bye.